My name is Bunny Crook. I'm married to Don Crook, and I help lead a missional community with him.
Hi, my name is Don Crook. I live in central Tacoma, and I help lead a missional community with my wife, Bunny. Bunny and I landed in Tacoma and at Soma in 2006 in the summer. We had been pointed that direction by our son, who thought we may be interested in such a different kind of church gathering. Well, we were. We gave it a try. And I remember that first Sunday, standing, singing, having a really good time, and noticing that, yep, we were the oldest people by quite a few years. But we loved it. We just loved the idea of hanging out with a lot of younger people, 20s, 30s, and maybe a few 40s. So we heard this message that day. It was, you are the church, so go be the church. That rang such a positive bell in us. We agreed it was biblical, and it was what we wanted to be doing, well, for the rest of our life. We had been part of a local church, a number of local churches, where there was certainly desire to see people won for Jesus, but it was always to be bringing the people to the church. This was different. Go be the church in Tacoma. So we got busy. We not only agreed that we were missionaries, but that we were learners. And so we began learning how to do missional living. Some really good books out there that we read. We went to, we took some classes. We visited several missional communities to try to get a sense of how they operated. We learned a lot, hopefully helped a little bit. Then we plugged into Soma School also. That was very helpful. In fact, it was the first Soma School. Soon after, we started knocking on doors. We planned to open our home on a Sunday at 10 o'clock. We figured the best time of the week when people are most available is Sunday morning before they head out in their day and their week. So we knocked on doors of people that we didn't know and introduced ourselves and invited them to our house for a spring celebration. Buy a plant, less than $5, and we'll have fun, exchange, and get to know one another. That was our start.
It wasn't always easy. It took us a while to figure out how we're going to have partners to lead with and how we're going to start, with an emphasis on our neighborhood, which is what we wanted. But being hospitable and opening our home is not hard for us to do. So we just started inviting people over, preparing our house. We actually built had built a playhouse in our backyard for children to be able to have fun with while we visited with their parents, which was a good move. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about meeting people. So we have neighbors that live right next door to us. We didn't know what country they were from, but we knew they weren't from America. And I invited them over for tea one day, and they chose to come. So I had the tea all ready and some strawberry shortcake ready, and learned that he is diabetic, so he couldn't eat the strawberry shortcake. But what happened was that it really came in handy that Don had read a couple of books on the country of Cambodia, because these people were from Cambodia and had gone through the difficult period of Cambodia's national life that they had. And so during the course of our conversation, we got out the atlas and looked at the country, and he began to tell us excitedly in his very difficult English about how they had been chased out of where they lived, separated as a couple, and how they had lived in the mountains and waited for the Red Cross to come and rescue them eventually. It was wonderful to get to know them. And the next time we had one of our celebrate spring times, we invited them to come, and Don was able to tell our other neighbors something about them, because they lived in real seclusion in their house. We had a very exciting thing happen when we celebrated Don's birthday with our neighbors over soup and salad on a Sunday, and we had about 14 people around the table, and Don asked everyone to share a story of their birthday. And we found out that day that this man, who's older than us, he's about 74 now, He had never had a birthday party. He had never had a birthday cake. He had never blown out candles. And so that next summer, when we were walking and praying and talking, we decided to go over and talk to Lou and ask him, could we celebrate your birthday this October? He agreed. Yes, he was happy that we remembered his story and that he would do that. That would be fine. So we were able to get ready for him, actually by having someone help us make signs in his own language. He was from Slovenia. And these signs were written birthday greetings according to how they celebrate birthdays in Slovenia, all over banners up in our living room. When he walked in the door, he was amazed. He just felt so loved and welcomed.
Part of my practice of life is to prayer walk. So I was prayer walking one day in the streets around our house, praying for people and who knows who else, what I was praying for. I met a man on his porch. As I walked by, I said hello, and he responded, and then God chipped in and said, I want you to talk to that man more. So I responded with a yes, and we got talking that first day. It was very good talk. We found we had a lot of things in common. I came back another day, and he invited me up to the porch, and another day into the house. And by that time, I had found out that he had cancer pretty seriously. But I also had a chance to share the gospel with him, actually by telling him how my father had become a Christian. And he identified with being born again, that he had been saved, and he just had really cooled off. So that gave us more opportunity. Me and then Bunny got involved with his wife also. And we shared more of the gospel, and he began to really grow. Another time, I became friends with a man who actually plugged into a redemption group. A man who was pretty quiet about his life, and not in really good spiritual health. The Lord used redemption group to open up his heart and for him to really see that he had really moved far away from the Lord. It really brought a revival to his life. He was a man who had chosen to find a nice, quiet country place and stay there in his retirement years with his wife. While the Lord, because I think he was growing in health and listening much more to the Lord called him to come to Tacoma and be a missionary in Tacoma and leave this retirement life as it was. Well, he sold that place and he moved, and he is in Tacoma these days, and he is one motivated man. Hallelujah.
So I guess I'd just like to suggest to other people who are our age or younger or even older that it works for us to be on mission in Tacoma with SOMA communities. And I would say one thing, be sure to really know what it is you're trying to do. Like, go ahead and go to a fast track or go to SOMA school, some way of really learning what it is that we're about, because it helps so much. And I guess I would also say that God has prepared us in these our later years to be able to interact with people in many and wonderful ways. He gave us the beautiful experience of having a man pray for us when we were only about 55 and told us that we would never retire, but that we would receive assignments from God every day. And when we came to Tacoma and began to live on mission in our neighborhood, that started to happen. And we have assignments from God many days in many different ways, and they're very exciting. So go ahead and give it a try, because it's wonderful. It's a very good way to live.